This is what I think is a really nice little attachment for a smartphone. There are two versions, so you do need to make sure that you order the correct one for your smartphone. One has a Type-C plug on it, and the other has an iPhone plug. It's very nicely packaged, and this was shipped in China in one of those flimsy plastic bags. It survived the trip quite well. This is a sturdy box. In here is the warranty card and an owner's manual of sorts, a little wrist strap or lanyard, and this is the insert for the box. You will find that this only fits in here in one direction, not the other. And this little carrying case is very well designed. And this camera only fits in here in one direction. There's a little indent, and that plug just fits in there, and then this will close. Try to put it in the other way, it will not fit. This is about the same length as a AA battery, and this plugs into the bottom of your phone, and this is the infrared camera. It works independent or separately from the smartphone cameras. When this is not being used, I strongly suggest you put it back in the case, put it back in the box, and that's the perfect way to store it. This is a much more powerful infrared camera than what I previously reviewed, the handheld self-contained unit. The main benefit is it's cheaper and utilizes the electronics of your smartphone and allows you to shoot a real-time video. I suggest you disregard this instruction manual. Go to the App Store and search for this camera. Install the app on your smartphone. And the first time you run the app with this camera installed, an instruction manual will pop up and it'll show you all the different control points on the camera. Then you can go to the manufacturer's website, click on this camera, and then you can open or download the instruction manual. The instruction manual on the website is quite detailed. On my phone, plug that in. And it will automatically open the application. You have to agree to a few things. You go to the camera. And here you can see the camera's up and running and taking pictures of my relatively cold fingertips. If the camera shuts off, you can restart it from the app. And the two things that I've found that are a little bit hard to get used to is the fact that the infrared camera lens is down here and not up here. So you have to bring this up to the subject. And sometimes this, when the camera starts, this will be reversed. Now I'm coming in from the right and my fingers are on the right. But if they show up on the left, you just go up here to the mirror image and change that setting. I'm going to show you the heat signature of this calendar. This is the hottest area here, and then you'll see the heat signature traveling up the wall. The radiant heat in the house has been on for a long time, and you can see from this image that the concrete has become evenly heated. With the factory settings on this camera, it's impossible to differentiate the location of the PECs inside the concrete. By adjusting the high and low temperatures and changing contrast and brightness, I can pick up the hot area on the surface of the concrete and follow the path of the PECs as it is located inside the concrete. The source is on the left-hand side, comes down the hallway, wraps around the corner. You can see a couple of brass candle stands that are sitting on the floor. This camera records a photo or video. It does not record audio, so I have to record the audio separately. And if we come around the other way, then the heat source is going through the dining and kitchen area. and then goes between the cabinets and leads to a back room. Looking at the coffee maker, the handle is actually on the left-hand side. So if you turn this off and mirror the image, now the handle is correctly displayed on the left-hand side. And then we can play with the display colors. This one is medical. And this is black and white, or grayscale. Here we're looking at my hand, and the color palette for this is hot iron. I have now adjusted the contrast and brightness to reduce the harshness of these colors. My left hand and the right hand, you can kind of see the hot spots in your hand due to blood flow. And then if I briefly touch a cup of hot coffee, it heats up the ends of my fingers. And then looking at my face, again in hot iron. And now we'll switch over to the medical palette. Look at the left hand and the right hand. Again, touching a cup of hot coffee. And then looking at my face. By adjusting the contrast and the brightness, you can get this display to be what you want for whatever your subject is. One possible use for the infrared camera is being able to scan your hotel or motel room to detect any hidden camera devices. If it is an electronic device and is powered, it should give off a heat signature. The closest thing I have to this is a night light that's plugged into a wall outlet. This light is turned off, but it still consumes power. And if I look at the servo clock that I made last year, the electronics are behind that piece of plywood, but it's heating up the plywood because those are always on. And down in the lower center part is an infrared sensor, and that gives off a very slight heat signature because it is always on. We're starting off with a cold engine. This is all cold brass, cold water. I've chosen this engine because it has a cooling tank and a water pump. You'll be able to see the head heat up, the exhaust, the spark plug will get hot over here. Warm water will come into the tank, it will return to the pump and come up to the bottom of the water jacket. And in time, you'll be able to see this column heat up. This infrared camera records video, but it does not record audio. So I'm recording audio on another camera. Water hose come off. This is a very powerful tool.